application, we have a special deal with the Vatican, and for this reason you have the priority entrance and the
slowly crumbling down, the book moving between the thick walls of the silver room. The whole corridor with those walls was hanging out to protect the church and all the precious things inside. A little room at the top revealed that there's 3.5 miles of galleries. But it's a real labyrinth.
Thank you. 19th century.
by the entrance of the old church. End of the Middle Ages.
Thank you so much.
Because we have This morning, yeah. When we were going.
Banks all along the river in the center of Rome are artificial banks. So this embankment was done 140 years ago, approximately. La Farnesina. He lived one of the wealthiest men of the time of the 16th century. This was the house of Agostino Chigi, who enjoyed to impress his friends, showing his wealth very close to the river. And he served lunch into gold dishes and cups. So he had everything made of gold. And then after lunch, the servants took all that stuff, and because for centuries Rome was located on the left bank, it was growing that way. So it was only at the time of Julius Caesar that the Romans occupied actually one of the quarters of Rome. Try not to pass exactly the same way as you have been in Rome, not everywhere, but as far as possible, we try to make a little bit different. So we're passing by the island, the eyes of the Roman history. It always played a very important role for the Romans, even more because the Romans also had a hospital on the island. You see this big building now, this is another hospital. Even nowadays, there's a hospital on the island. Just the reason was a guest house for ladies with children but without a husband. So they were guested here in this house. They learned a job, so most of them became tailors, but even live a decent life with their children. That was built in the Renaissance. As I told you, in those days, the popes invested money. I mean, the popes of the women. Now that we have crossed the Tiber River, we are at the bottom of the Aventine. This is the last of the seven hills of Rome. You see Roman remains everywhere. Here there were a lot of warehouses. So there's ruins you see among the trees going up on the hill. Pass.
Valentine Hill.
So look on your left, Palatine Hill, and those are the palaces of the emperors, the residences of the emperors on the top of the hill. There were beautiful villas once, just the houses of the wealthiest families. One of the men who lived there was Augustus, first Roman emperor. He lived there with his own wife, with Livia. Wanted a big palace on this side of the hill. Then came Caligula, the craziest of them all. He wanted it. Till they really occupied the entire Palatine Hill. And all those palaces were covered with the marble, but some of the marble that we have seen in the Vatican Museum on the floors. So that gives us an idea how those palaces were looking like. So covered up with colored marble. In the valley, there was a... As I told you, if you're not coming with me into the Colosseum, you can simply stay on board. So our... Domenico, I'm sorry, we'll take you back to the hotel so that you talk to her, you'll find her in the hotel.
And then with her, you coming back downtown to pick us up, and we continue to the catacombs. So now, we are at the bottom of an amphitheater built...
The Arch of Constantine.
You haven't got that map in your bag, have you?
Thank you.
rectangular building with a large window in the centre, and that is the podium. It was quite nothing to see. So before they started the excavation, the podium was a church. The decoration, which was more walls, till they got back to the naked walls. One of the most popular churches of Rome to get married. And my mother was young, because that was the place where. But look down, the Roman Empire, the beating heart of the empire. You should listen into trials. So now we recognize better a couple of buildings. We see the Arch of Septimus and columns. Those three big columns to the left, that was the Temple of Castor and Pollux. Castor and Pollux were the divinities.
Aquí a la derecha, ¿no?
Sí.
So
the Jews and Christians.
Where the chariot race.
Jews and Christians had a different way to bury people than the Romans had and the Pagans had. We are outside the city center, the historical center. We have the time of Mussolini. You can see some of the houses of that period. Of the supporters of Mussolini. Now we are just by the side of the walls. City walls of Rome. 12 miles of brick walls. Built in only 7 years. That tells us how scared the Romans were. With this city, the Romans didn't want to have a fence. But in the 3rd century, things changed, and very quickly. And so the Romans wanted the walls. In only 7 years, they built 12 miles of brick walls, and they even had the time to innovate, because the towers that you see projecting out of the walls were an innovation done by the Romans. So that.
I didn't bring my movie camera because I thought I would do it with this.
All on your left. And we also see an Egyptian obelisk that maybe not everybody can. 500 years old. On your right hand side, the obelisk, the entrance of the church. Soon we will see also the front wall.